This video lecture will cover the thick filament, which is a myofilament structure, in muscle. So to begin, it's important for you to realize when you look at a sarcomere, and again, a sarcomere extends from a Z disc to a Z disc, and this is one sarcomere, and that sarcomere consists of both thin and thick filaments. Here we will only focus on the thick filaments. To begin, your thick filament consists of one myosin molecule. So in this one myosin molecule, it consists of two fibrous proteins, which are called a dimer, and these are the tails. The other structure that makes up the one myosin molecule are the heads. The heads are also proteins, but they're globular proteins. Let's take a look at what structures you would find on the heads of the myosin molecule. There are two structures found on each head of the myosin molecule. These include the ATPase site and the actin binding site. So let's take a look at each of these sites. Let's focus on the ATPase site first. The ATPase sites, again, there's an ATPase site on each head. This is where ATP binds. And when ATP binds to this site, that will break your cross bridge. And then ATP can be hydrolyzed. So when it's hydrolyzed, remember your products are ADP plus a phosphate. And when ATP is hydrolyzed after breaking the cross bridge, the head of your myosin is in the high energy state. That'll be very important when you learn about cross bridge cycling. Now let's focus on the actin binding site. So the actin binding site is also located on each head. The actin binding site binds to the myosin binding site on the thin filament. Remember specifically that the myosin binding site is found on actin. Remember, actin is your green olive. So when the actin binding site binds to the myosin binding site on the thin filament, what does that form? That forms a cross bridge. And remember that when you form a cross bridge, what mechanical event can take place? Contraction. So that is the basic scenario for one myosin molecule, one thick filament. In reality, let's take a look at what happens when I join a second myosin molecule. Notice the direction of the heads for each of these molecules. The heads are pointing in opposite directions. That's an important concept because if you visualize the heads moving straight up and binding to the thin filament, then cocking inward, when they cock inward, that shortens the muscle. Now, the thick filament is actually more complicated than that, of course, correct? Because this is physiology, and you guys know nothing in physiology is easy, right? Look at how many myosin molecules make up a thick filament.